So I'll start with a general definition of borderline personality disorder. And we typically use the acronym BPD. So I might use the acronym as I answer this question. So BPD is one of 10 personality disorders that were described for the first time probably about 50 years ago in the literature, but has not been diagnosed in adolescence until very recently. And so BPD refers to a disorder characterized by 9 traits: anger, impulsivity, emotionality, a sense of emptiness, problems in interpersonal relationships. And it is a disorder, like I say, that has been diagnosed in adults for about 30 years, but in adolescence it hasn't been diagnosed until very recently. And it is because research has not until very recently supported the diagnosis of BPD in adolescence. And so one of the big questions was in the beginning whether the adult presentation of BPD is applicable to teenagers. And what research has shown in the last 10, 15 years is that those 9 criteria that define BPD in adolescence, in adults, can be readily used in adolescents like it is in adults. The big question is whether we can already identify some of these traits in pre-adolescence, in 7 to 11-year-old children, for instance. And at the moment, the consensus is that it really is in adolescence that we see this adult presentation of BPD, but not in pre-adolescence. So in pre-adolescence, we can look at, for instance, emotionality, or emotional instability or reactivity or impulsivity, but not really the full disorder as we find it in adults. In adolescents, we feel comfortable now to say that an adolescent can have this presentation of an adult-like BPD. No, not really. What has changed is our ability to identify it. So 50 years ago, we didn't really consider BPD as one of the a main disorder. There was confusion as to whether BPD is a separate disorder from, for instance, bipolar disorder or depression or anxiety or antisocial behavior. Over the last 50 years, we have in our research come to the conclusion that BPD exists as a separate disorder and that we can therefore diagnose it. And so the diagnosis in adults is now readily made. And like I say, in the rest of the world, we are beginning to make that diagnosis in adolescents as well. So it's not so much that the disorder increased in prevalence, but more that we are now more able to make the disorder. We have more knowledge to make the diagnosis. That's a very important question, and one that I spend a lot of time on. The main causation for personality disorder in general, and BPD in particular, is that a person is born with a very sensitive temperament. We sometimes think about people with BPD as having no skin. You know how we have 7 layers of skin. People with BPD have perhaps just 1 layer of skin, or, you know, just it's a very sensitive temperament. And so when a child is born, children vary in their temperament and how sensitive they are. And some children are just much more sensitive than other children, and they need more from a parent in order to help them with that sensitivity. And so they will be more reactive to the environment, these children. They will be more emotional. And those children will need more from the parent to help them regulate their responses to the environment. And so we talk about a construct called mentalization, which means that you are keeping the mind of the child in mind. It means that when you are responding to the child, you are trying to think about what the world feels like from the perspective of the child. And so the parent is in actual fact regulating a lot of the environment for the child. So the resilience that the child needs against their own temperament, sensitive temperament, has to come from the parent. The parent has to help buffer a lot of the sensitivity for the environment. And in doing so, what the parent is really helping the child with is validating their subjective experiences. And that enables the child to develop a strong sense of self. And that is what enables them to have an integrated personality as they go into adolescence. And adolescence is the time when they're gonna integrate pieces of personality, and it's very important that the parent mentalizes the child so that at when they get to adolescence, they have the scaffolding needed to do that work of identity consolidation. In essence, that's what personality disorder is. It is an incoherent identity.